Hey, Epic House, I'm Brad, and this is what's happening in the house. Hey, Epic House, just blew in from a snowstorm in Sherwood. I wish, right? But here's the deal, okay? Christmas Eve is so important. We're going to do it online, but online and in live at 1 o'clock, 2:30, and 4 o'clock. 4 o'clock's already sold out, so we have limited seats. So go register, please. Go register online, okay? That following Sunday, just a couple days later, the 27th, will be online only. So do that in your PJs. We'll interact with you, do some emojis, all that. It's going to be awesome. And then lastly, you guys have been so incredibly generous with this the Sherwood Family Christmas Fund. We're doing that. We've already received a lot, but you guys are incredibly generous. If you have not done that yet, whether it's $20, $25, $100, whatever it might be, it would be awesome if you'd contribute. Just go online, you can contribute to that, and you can really make a Merry Christmas for a lot of kids just right here in Sherwood. So God bless you, and Merry Christmas. Hey, Epic House, I'm telling you, we have an incredible gift for you. So just take a look at this.
'Twas the night before Christmas, and behind every door, each creature was streaming Bible studies galore. The subscription had come to our inbox with care. No more libraries or bookstores we could watch anywhere. The children were nestled all snug in their beds, with veggies and owls and God's Word in their heads. And Mama and I, with the presents all stashed, away to the iPad we flew like a flash. Now Francis, now Chandler, now Ramsey, now Jenny, on Tony, on Kyle, on JD and Timmy. Marriage and parenting for groups big or small. Now teach away, teach away, teach away all. Thousands of studies on a digital shelf. I laughed when I saw them in spite of myself. And all of them free, a gift from the church. Merry Christmas to all, and to all a good search.
So isn't that amazing? Here's the thing, this is how you get the gift, okay? Go to epichouse.tv. That's not Epic House Church, although there'll be a link to it from epichouse.church, but we've got another site, epichouse.tv, that has all these media opportunities for you, your children, for marriage, for all sorts of different incredible issues. So just go there, okay? Fill out the form, and then you will get an email from Right Now Media, okay? Now know this too, we will not share your email with anybody else. We will probably use it to just inform you what's going on at Epic House, which you'll want to know, right? So anyway, Merry Christmas from us to you. God bless you.
To celebrate this Christmas, my name is Kim. start thinking shepherds and wise men, I need to tell you that this Christmas story is one you've never heard before. That's because we're going to step back in time. Time before shepherds and wise men. Before the manger. Even before my visit to Mary. We're going to step all the way to when the angels found out about the birth of Jesus. After all, that's when Christmas really began. To the main characters in this little history lesson. First, there's Michael. He is an archangel, and now there's only one archangel in heaven. And in case you haven't guessed, that means he's pretty important. In fact, next to God, he's kind of the head honcho around here.
Thank you all for coming today. I have a very important announcement to make.
Next, there's Sarah. She's the head of the seraphims. And a bit of a know-it-all, I'm afraid.
The seraphims came as soon as we got Mrs. Michael, and as you can see, my entire delegation is here.
Splendid, Sarah.
You need to know who Cherry is. She's the head of the cherubims and a real angel.
Michael, we're so honored that you included us.
Of course you're included. I wanted all the angels to be here.
Next is good old Harold. He's in charge of the herald angels. Or should I say the herald angels are in charge of Harold.
Harold, I'm glad our delegation is here.
Thanks, Michael. Wait, why did he say he called us here again?
He has a big announcement to make.
Oh, that's right. Glad to be here.
Last but not least, there's Moses and Isaiah. They head up the delegation of the minor and major prophets.
It's a beautiful day for a meeting, isn't it, Michael?
Too many clouds to me.
Yes, Isaiah, it is a beautiful day for a meeting.
Still say there's too many clouds.
Well, I think that Michael is ready to tell us why we've all been called here. So I better scoot and give this horn a toot.
Aww. My fellow angels, we've got a problem. We got eye trouble. Moses.
I spent 40 years in the boonies as a self-centered wilderness wanderers.
Oh yes, I remember your problems. As I recall, you and the children of Israel never did quite see eye to eye.
Very funny, but you're right. It was bad news.
How bad was it?
It was so bad, the Lord had to come down to earth just to get their attention.
Commandments were perfect, but man wasn't.
You better believe it. After all the drama the Lord went to show man how to live close to God, they still came on worshiping other gods, making graven images, taking the Lord's name in vain.
Calm down, Moses. Calm down. Everyone knows what a bad time you've had. It's bad news for all us prophets.
How bad was it?
It was so bad, I had to constantly be telling the people God had a plan. You see, that's the good news. God had always had a plan. Why, that's probably what Michael is leading up to now.
I don't know, Isaiah. You always were an optimist.
Of course I was.
I still am, because I've got something to be optimistic about. And if all the angels will help me out, I'll tell you what I told my people all those years. Major leaguers, we struck out too.
We got eye trouble.
God used Moses, the major prophets, and the minor prophets to tell the people how to live close to him. But none of them succeeded. And things have gotten so bad.
How bad was it?
Cut that out. Now, as I was saying, things have gotten so bad that the Lord has decided to put into action the plan of the centuries. An announcement like this demands fanfare, Gabriel. I'm happy to announce that God decided to go to Earth.
What?
No.
No. But God hasn't lived on Earth since creation.
Yes, but that was before there was any eye trouble.
That's right. Don't you remember? Everything was beautiful on Earth. man felt so close to God. God walked with Adam and Eve in the cool of the evening. There was no sin, no death, just peace and happiness. Then that old stinker Lucifer. He decided he would be as powerful as God. So of course God had no choice but to kick him and his whole rotten crew out of heaven. And things have been fine ever since.
Of course they have. That wasn't the end of Lucifer. Since he went to Earth, things have gone from good to bad to worse.
Sure, but everyone knows the devil's gonna get it in the end.
Of course he will. But in the meantime, God has got to find a way to be close to man again.
We understand that, Michael, but does he actually have to come down to Earth and live among them?
Yeah, why would he want to do that?
There's a very good reason why. You see.
Why?
Why would he leave a place where angels fly to, live where men walk to and fro?
I just wanna know, just wanna know, just wanna know.
I don't know why in heaven God would want to go.
My God would make such a great sacrifice.
Why?
Because God loves man.
Of course, God loves everyone.
Wait a minute. I can see how God loves us, but we're angels. How can he love people who are so, let's just face it, so sinful?
Like I said, it doesn't make sense to us. But the fact is, God loves people not for what they are, but for what they can be.
Well, all I can say is that must be the best kind of love there is.
Thank you.
he gonna get to Earth?
What's he gonna be?
What'll he go as?
Well, you're not gonna believe this, but I was so excited I forgot to ask. Wait just a minute, I'll be right back.
Just imagine all the ways God could go to Earth.
Yeah, God's got the power to do anything. I wonder how he'll go.
Well, it's certain you can never predict exactly what God has in mind, but it wouldn't hurt to try.
A baby?
A baby? There's nothing really special about a baby.
Yeah, why would he want to go as a baby?
He has a very good reason why. You see, for centuries, God has been trying to accomplish something he has not had since creation. And the only way he can do it is to become a baby.
He wants to be close to his children, so he'll become a child. A helpless little baby, a savior meek and mild. He'll leave his home in heaven to prove his love is real and be born as a baby.
Planned it. God knew if he went to Earth as someone important in the world's eyes, that a lot of people could feel like they could never approach him, never be close to him.
Then a baby's a wonderful idea.
Michael, what will his name be?
That's the best part. His name will be Jesus. It means Savior, because he will save his people from dying in their sins.
In that case, everyone will want to come to him.
No, I'm afraid not everyone will want to come to him.
But why?
What's that old eye trouble again? People have got it so bad that they are blinded to the fact that being close to Jesus is the best place to be.
Is there any cure for them?
There certainly is. All they have to do is take their eyes off themselves and look to Jesus.
You will find in him an everlasting friend. So come.
houses. And isn't it a beautiful plan? Just think, we get to celebrate the birth with the angels and us prophets, part of the heavenly host, praising God and singing.
Shall not perish, but have eternal life.
Thank you.
Wow, wasn't that an awesome kids program? I mean, Christmas is like all about kids, isn't it? It's just so incredible. So a couple things you can do, okay? First, fill out a connection card. We really, really want to hear from you. We want to connect with you. And then, you know, just pray that everything goes well and we continue to stay safe from COVID-19. So God bless you, and we'll see you hopefully Christmas Eve, if not here, online.